Today I would like to review with you some of the basics of C and C++. And to do this, I will write a program. So I want to print my name. So if you are you attended on Tuesday, I will repeat one part of Tuesday's class because most of the students were not present. If I would like to print my name, then I can do this. Is this correct? Will this print my name?
No.
Why not? Ah, quotation, very good. Inshallah, starting from next lecture, I will give you bonus points for smart answers. Fine, is this correct?
Semicolon.
Ah, semicolon, mutez. Is this correct? Yes, no. This statement is correct. الأمر الواحد بروحه is correct. But is this going to run?
No.
Why not? What is missing?
No.
Ah, there are many things that are missing. First thing, any program must have the main function. The main function. So the main is called a function. Why? Because the compiler looks for a main function. If it finds the main function, it executes. It executes only يقوم بتنفيذ, only what is inside the main. Because anything else is not executed. And if there is no main, it's an error. طيب. So is this going to run? No, because the missing include. Why do you need include? So let's try without include. What will happen? Let's run this. I will upload this code on Moodle. So if you cannot write after me, it's okay. It says an error because cout was not declared. What does declare mean? Exactly. So declared was not explained. The compiler doesn't know cout, but cout is a command from C++. How can the compiler does not understand it? Because it is included in the library. So I must bring it from the library. Include iostream, and the name is not cout. The name is official name is standard cout. But instead of writing every time I write cout, I write standard. Then exactly, I can write it only one time at the beginning and using namespace std. Very good. Shukran, shukrak. Include, we call it a macro or preprocessor. So there is no semicolon, but using is a statement, so it ends with a semicolon. So now let me run. Is it going to run? What do you think?
No.
What is missing? Return zero. Actually, when I taught you last year, I told you you must have return zero. It is going to work without return zero, but it is a warning. Since this function, this is a function, returns an int, now you studied 101. In 100, I couldn't tell you why we need return zero. I just told you must put return zero. But since the main function, this is a function, returns an int, then it is a warning, not an error, not to return anything from the function. So it is better. Yes, thank you very much. I had forgotten about it because it runs. Sometimes your program may run, but it still contains small errors or warnings that the compiler can understand. And let's run it again. And now this is going to print my name. Any problems? No. Let's make it more difficult. I would like to draw a line under my name, like this. Hazel. And then a ruler under my name. How can I do this? For example, minus. Yes. Very good. See out And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Semicolon, of course. Is it going to run?
No.
Why not? End line. Why do I need the end line? Because, yes, the compiler executes exactly what I did here. No space, no new line. So where do I put the new line?
After
the name. So now is this going to run correctly? Yes. So the errors we did, the mistakes we did at the beginning, are called, this for your information, are called syntax errors. If you forget a semicolon, missing, we call this syntax error. It is an error and the program is not going to run. But when I forgot the end line, the program still runs but produces incorrect results. It's called runtime error. Syntax error and runtime error are two kinds of error. Usually students in the lab know the syntax error, because if your program has a syntax error, it is not going to run. But if you have a runtime error, the program is going to run and you think it is correct, but it produces the wrong results. Now I would like to introduce variables. You remember variables? What is a variable? A variable is a recipient, like a wa'ab. A variable is a place in memory, is a location in memory that can contain information. So we call this a variable. So this variable has a name. Each variable must have a name and a place in memory. The compiler takes care of reserving it takes care of reserving a place in memory. So here I'm going to declare a variable called text. This variable will contain the string that I would like to print. So what does string mean? String is the type, as you can see, type def. It is the type of the data you will store. Because in memory, you can put any data. You can put numbers. You can put characters, individual characters, A, B, C. You can put a whole string, a whole word, a whole sequence of characters. A string is a sequence of characters. And what is text? Text is the name of the variable, the name of the variable. So here I'm going to do it differently. Text equals Hazm, is assigned the value of Hazm, my name. So now, what do I need to see out?
Text.
Should I see out like this?
No.
What happens if I put the quotation?
Print text.
Yes, exactly. It is going to print text, but this is not what I want. I don't want to print text. What should I write instead? Remove the quotation mark. If I remove the quotation marks, it is going to search in my program for a variable with the name text. If it does not find this variable, it's an error. If it finds that variable text, then it prints the value inside text. What is the value inside text? Very good. So now it works exactly the same way. Can you put different values inside inside the variable? Yes. The same variable can contain, for example, has it. And then you want to put another thing, for example, this line. Can the variable contain both at the same time? No. If you enter new data, it overwrites, tamhu the old value in the variable. So variables are volatile. تم إعادة الكتابة فورا. So they are overwritten. For example, here I'm going to write text equals 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay? And here, see out text. So now I put a new value in text and I see out text for the second time. And it produces exactly the same thing, but here we are using variables. So now I explain to you the variables. Type. Some of you took Python in in C100, but some of you took C++ in 100. So for those who took Python, we always told you that in Python, each command should be on a separate line. Is this the same thing for C++?
No.
So we call this a format-free language. C++ is format-free. This is for your information. I'm not going to give like a question like this in the exam. Is C++ format-free?
Exactly.
Format-free. Format-free language. Format-free language, it means that you can put more than one command on one line. For example, I can do this. And I can do this. Okay? So I put more than one command on. How does C++ understand that those are two separate commands?
Semicolon.
Because there is. So semicolon is used to separate the commands. I can do this. One line. Okay? I can do this, one line. Everything on one line. I can do this, put on one line. All the program on one line. I can also do this, on one line. And this. So the whole program is put on one line. But is it good practice? هل من يعني الممارسات الطبيعية? Why you don't do this? It is difficult to read, so it is not good. But it is correct. So if you run, I can put this also on one line. But yes, because there is a semicolon. But I cannot put this on the same line because there is no semicolon. This is why it is called preprocessor. خلاص. So now, even though the program is on one line, it runs. But please don't do this because it is difficult to read. So now I'm going to get back to the normal program. This is how you should write your program in a nice way. Sometimes I prefer writing related commands on the same line. This is my choice, but you don't have to do this. For example, I prefer a variable and then print that variable. Now, I would like to repeat this two times. How do I do this? One of the ways, like this. Is this correct? Is this going to print Hazm and then line and then Hazm and then line? Let us see, because sometimes we are in a hurry to write a good program fast. No, not correct.
We can't do
end line.
Oh.
Yes, very good. So if this was next week, I can give you bonus, but today no bonus. So first thing, what is missing is an end line. Okay, so we need also to put an inserter and end line. So now is this going to work correctly? Yes, but what if you want to repeat it 5 times, 10 times? Then then in this case we need a loop. So I would like to repeat it 5 times, because when I tried at home, 5 times is the maximum that can appear here in this screen. So I want to show it all. So how do you write a loop? Remember? Do you remember?
For loop or while loop?
Exactly. So since it is fixed number of times, then it is, yes, easier to use the for. For what?
Starting point.
Starting point, but you need a counter, a variable, I, and you need to declare that variable before using. In C++, every variable must be declared, يتم الإعلان عنه, before using it. So I can declare it inside the for, or I can declare it here. I can do int I here and inside the loop for I equals 0. Let me start the easy way. I equals 1, I smaller than or equal to 5, I plus plus. خلاص. This is one of the ways. Another way is not to declare in this line. So I put and declare inside the. What is the difference?
Let's go.
كلام المحترم جدا. طيب, maybe not everybody understood what Naji said. Here, if you declare your variable inside the loop, it works only inside the loop. Outside the loop, you don't know what is I. But if you declare the I here, outside, then it is valid for the whole program. Very good. So we call this the scope. Scope, اللي هو المجال in which this variable is to be seen, used. طيب, what did I do here? I did not delete int I. I just put two slash. What does two slash? It is a comment. Comment starts with two slashes until the end of the line, and it means that this thing is not to be compiled and executed in the program. Very good. So I think you know the basics of C. I prefer to use this int declare inside the loop. Let's see what is this going to do. Is it going to run correctly?
No. طب خلينا
نشوف. What is going to happen? It prints one time. Why one time? بالضبط. This for loop. But this for loop. الحقيقة أنا متفاجئ. This for loop, what is the meaning of the for loop? أنا مش متفاجئ. The for loop executes 5 times only one line, the first line after the for. The rest is outside the loop, so only one time. So it puts the value Hazm inside text 5 times, like this. Hazm, and then erase and write Hazm again, nothing. And then erase and write Hazm again 5 times, so nothing changed. So what do we need? yes, very good. So Mona?
May.
Huh? May. So May said we need brackets, but Naji said we need braces. Of course, I will not ask you in the exam what is the difference between brackets and braces. Bracket we use in arrays. Bracket are like this, square brackets. And braces, we use them for the beginning and start of blocks. The curly braces, curly المموجة. خلاص. This is just for your information, but of course when you said bracket, I understand you. Because you cannot put a bracket here. أنا فاهمكم على طول وبتغلبوني في الامتحانات بالفهم ده. تتعشموا إن أنا فاهم على طول. And you write very, very difficult English, and I cannot understand what you are writing. بس فهمكم. طيب خلاص. So now, is it going to run correctly?
No.
Why not? طب what were you worried about? الآن منه إيه؟ What did you think was the mistake? Maybe I can try to explain. So now it ran correctly, but maybe there is a mistake. أنت بتقول إيه؟
لأن الأسايمنت صار داخل الفور لوب. لا بس
تحبطت. لو كانت برا أفضل. Ah, Naji is suggesting one thing, that why do you need to assign inside the loop? Why don't you put the assignment outside the loop? I put the assignment inside the loop because I use one variable only. Which assignment do you want to take outside the loop? This one, for example?
Yeah.
Then you know what is going to happen if I do this.
No.
It will be a problem. So it is going to write Hazm one time and then 5 lines. So what? No, cout must be inside. What Najee is suggesting is not that this is wrong and I will do a correct program. He says this program is not efficient. ليس يعني الكفاءة is not fast, because why do you need to assign text to Hazem inside the room? So the summary of this is that there are many ways to solve one problem, and this is why some students think that programming is difficult. Because programming is like mathematics. There are many ways to solve the same problem. All the ways are correct. But students want to memorize only one way. So what Najee was suggesting, I can make the same program faster. For example, by taking this text outside, but he found that the other text will be a problem. It is okay to think like this. But inshallah, if you just want, you are after the grade in the GPA, then I will give you some problems to memorize.
And, line 9 and 10,
yes.
Five times.
Can I remove this one and this one also?
Yes.
But it is going to print only my name without the rule under it. So it is going. So this is what I will do in the exams. For example, of course, I'm not going to bring this in the exam. But I will, because this is very easy problem, so it will not be in the exam. But for example, I can give you in the problems the original code, and in the exam the code, but without those two lines, to see if you understood. Because يعني من فضلك try to understand how the program runs, not memorize code output. If I remove this, then it is going to run correctly, but it is going to print my name only without the rule. So those are the small modification, التغييرات البسيطة, that and I can do in the exam. But they will be very similar, as I said on Sunday, to the tutorial problems. So you not just solve tutorial problems and memorize تحفظ الحل, solve and understand. If you understand, then it will be fine. For I, from 1 until 5, okay? 1 included, 2, 3, 4, 5, how many?
5.
Can I do it like this? There are many ways. From 0 until less than 5. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. I don't reach 5 because 5 is not smaller than 5. Why do C++ programmers prefer this method over the previous method? Because there is one less character. C++ programmers are very stingy. Bukhala. You don't want to waste time and space by writing an equal here. So if you do from 0 until 5, it is still understandable. It is 5 times. And you save one character. خلاص؟ بنتحاسب بالفلس. طيب. Sometimes old programmers like me, we used to do it like this. 5. Is this going to work? 5 times also?
Let me.
I minus minus. What did I do here? From 5 to 0, I minus minus. It means? Yeah, you are. Start at 5. And then 4, 3, 2, 1. And stop at 1. Why? Because 0 is not larger than 0. It is equal to 0. Why is this slightly better? But anyway, it's correct. Oh, hasn't 5 times with the rule. Because all comparisons inside the computer compare to 0. So if you compare to 5, what happens is that it does not make I less than 5. I minus 5 less than 0. It always compares to 0. Computer can only compare numbers to zeros. خلاص? So sometimes this is faster. And I want to teach you something different. If I do this, I from 0 until 10. And I want 5 times only. What should I do here?
2.
Yes.
Increment by 2.
Increment by 2. Do you understand what Najee is saying? increment by 2. So from 0 until 10, but increment step 2, and this is going to produce the same results. So for example, I can give you in the tutorial the problem from 0 until 5, and in the exam from 0 until 10, step 2. So this way you must understand. Okay? And there are many ways to solve this problem correctly. Time. We have some time, so I would like to introduce a function. You studied function in 101, everybody. Let me make it the easy way now. From 0 to 5, I++. And before I use function, I want to make sure this is running correctly. Yes, it is running correctly. 5 times. Mumtaz. So now I would like to tell you about functions. I will define a function. I will declare a function. The function is called print name 5. I can call the function anything. How do I know it is a function? Function always have parentheses. So we call those types of bracket parentheses. The function returns nothing. The function, I will use this function to print only. How do you call a function that does not return anything? Void function. Void function. And what I will do inside this function is like this. Yes. I will take this code and put it here. Cut and paste. So this function, we don't need the int here. So what does this function do? This function prints my name 5 times. Okay? Can I run this program? طيب. أيوه. جميل جدا ما شاء الله. أنا سعيد جدا بيكم. Yes, when I write this, when I run this program, the program doesn't do anything because we already agreed, اتفقنا على, that only the commands that are inside main are executed. Where are the commands inside main? Nothing. So, how about this? This is a function definition. تعريف لفunction. It tells you that this function, if it is called, اسمه كي؟ بتاعت الكول دي. Hanan said the function must be called. خلاص? Like for example, I don't know the name of Hanan, so if I don't call her, she will not answer me. I must know the name and then call that name. For here I know the name, print name 5, but I didn't call it. So this is why we need to call. How do you call the function? Do you write void print? Only the name of the function and لا اللي هنا ما فيش arguments يبقى the parentheses. Why? Because I need to tell compiler that this is a function, not a variable. Without parentheses, it's a variable, not a function. Is there something missing? ممتاز good. Semicolon. Now if I run this program, what happens? The same thing. It will going to print my name 5 times because now I call the function and the function does the same job. Now I would like to print another name. What should I do? If I want to print, for example, the name Naji. Should I put it here? Change here, but every time do I need to change the function to print a different name? C++ offers me an easier way to print, to pass information to the function. I would like to pass information to the function. Instead of changing the function every time, I want the function to be fixed, never changed. And I change the function call only. So this makes it more professional for programming. For example, here I'm going to write string text. خلاص. So I don't need that line at all. خلاص. This is a comment. I will remove it completely. عشان تتلخبطوش. But then I don't want to write here. This is not good. So I'll put another string line equals 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. خلاص. Five dashes. And here I don't need this anymore. And I will see out the line. So I will see out the name that comes from outside. This is what I will do here. Hazem. And I will pass it, يتم تمريره inside the function through عن طريق the variable text. And then I will use that text to print here and then just print the line. So let me check that this is working. What happened? Ah, there is an error. This is very good. I like errors. Why do we like errors? Because it teaches us how to do it correctly. I used single quotation. Here it should be double quotation. Single quotation is for one character. Double quotation is for entire string. This was an easy error, so I'm not very happy. I like difficult errors because when you have difficult errors, you spend a lot of time learning. So now what happens? This function not only is called and I pass a value to it. I pass the string hasm here inside, which is printed as the name. So why is this better than the other way? Because then I can put anything here. I can put Naji. And I did not change the function. The one function can be saved in a library. So it is going to print Naji five times with the line. I can put May, then it is going to print May five times. So even though the function was not changed, but now I can change only the parameter, the argument, I mean. And this will be the way to pass the text inside the function. Type. Yes, I think this is the end of today's lecture. We learned for loop, we learned functions, we learned arguments. Order? Thank you.